guys, welcome back to the channel this week. My name is Karina, for those of you who don't know. I'm also known as the Artistic Newfie here on YouTube and other platforms as well. All my links are down in the description below. This week we're doing something a little bit different. I actually have a sponsored video, and the company Carmel has sent me some paint markers to try out. Before we get into working with the markers here, let's hop over to their website so I can kind of show you what other kind of products they have and give you a little bit of information about them. And then we'll go through some more information about the markers as we do the art project. So if you want to see what we're going to create today with these markers, make sure to stay tuned for the rest of the video.
All right, guys, so we'll just take a quick look at their website here, where you can find all the information, all different colors that they offer for this particular paint marker. Up at the top of the site as well, they have a lot of different other items that they offer when it comes to mediums. There's inks, there's pens, there's crayons, all kinds of different things. There's some instructional videos, and at the bottom there is a little link that you can click on where you can go in to see the costs of the markers and what have you. So I went and I changed the dollar to Canadian currency so I can show you guys in my currency what the markers would cost. But you can go in and change it to wherever you are, whether you're in the United States or Canada. I'm not 100% sure if they ship outside of that, but you can see how much the markers are. They do, if you do buy them in like a larger set, then you do save a little bit of money. And it's kind of neat that they have other products there to use as well, especially if you're doing something industrial or if you want to use these markers to create artwork, or, you know, just to have some different things that you wouldn't normally find in an art store. Maybe there's something on here that would pertain to you. So go give them, go check out their website, have a look it over, and see if there's something there that interests you.
All right, guys, so before I actually get into trying the paint markers, I just want to show you what they look like, and we're going to do a bit of a swatch test. They kind of have like an industrial type feel to them. The marker is not really heavy, but it's, I don't know if it's plastic, I can't tell. The nibs are very easy to come out, apparently. We'll put that back in there. I do have the larger bullet nib. I think I may have preferred to get the smaller size nib because I like to do a lot of detail work with the like markers like this, but that's okay. We're gonna make it work. So what I have here is I have a couple pieces of wood and a backup piece right here in case I need to use it. I'm going to attempt to make a sunset with these because I like to do, you know, paintings and whatnot. I figure I may as well use it as a paint marker. I do have some paint brushes here, right here, just in case I do need to cheat and I need to work with a paintbrush just a little bit, but I kind of want to try to use these markers as they are. Now, the wood that I have is not, it is a smooth surface and it's not a smooth surface, so I don't know how it's going to go, but apparently these are good with a smooth surface. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a swatch of all of them. The rest of the video here is going to be time lapse. I'm going to talk over that and I'll show you each of the different colors of markers and on here, and then we'll move into doing kind of like a test on the wood here. So we'll see how that goes. I mean, I may have to scrap the wood and try something else, so this may be attempt number one. We'll see what happens. All right, so let's jump into the speed paint and the swatching, and let's see how this goes.
All right, so we'll go in and give you some more information about the markers that I received and kind of give you an idea of how it was working with them and if I would use them again, if I would recommend them, and what have you. So here you can see that I'm doing some swatches, and I come to realize that the blue cap and the white cap were mixed up. I don't know if I did that or if they came like that. Not a big deal. So I just switched the caps back. I was a little bit intrigued with the blue cap. It was kind of metallic, but the paint marker itself was not. So I don't know if it was just the look of the cap, or if maybe this should have been a metallic marker. I have no clue. Either which way, the markers, they didn't take that long to activate. So it may sound like I'm reading a little bit here because I am, because I made notes. I wanted to make sure I did my research with these markers and to give you guys a good enough explanation as to what they are. So just to get started here, they are, I'm going to probably butcher these words. They're xylene and toluene free. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. They are weather and fade resistant and they're long lasting. So I'm assuming by that it means that they are waterproof. That's what I'm getting. The nibs are replaceable, so if you're using the markers and the nibs wear out, you can replace them. It applies easily to a smooth surface, and right here I'm using the wood, so it's not 100% smooth surface, but you can get a nib for rougher material, so that's a possibility as well. But they did work fairly decent here on the wood planks or wood slices I'm using, I guess. These markers are not kid friendly. I would not recommend children to use these unless you have maybe an older responsible child in the household that can probably wear a respirator, because these markers, they stink. They don't smell pleasant. I know some people have a really bad sensitivity to smells. If you can't tolerate a Sharpie, you will not tolerate these markers. They are very potent, so you should use them in a well-ventilated area. They are also flammable, so I would not use them around heat, to keep them in a nice safe space away from any kind of flame. And I think the reason why they're flammable, because they do contain denatured ethyl alcohol. I hope I'm saying that properly. They also contain methoxy and propanol. I'm butchering these words, but this is what's in the markers. It says so right on the tube, okay? So you can also get these markers in a fine nib. You can, I already mentioned, you can get the hard nibs for rougher materials. There's multiple different colors that you can get. They even have some metallic colors as well. The company is located in Montreal, Quebec, Canada, so they are local. Not really local, but you know, they're in the same country as I am, so that's kind of cool. So it's nice to get a brand that wants to work with you, that it's in the same country. Usually it's brands from the States or, you know, products from even China. Companies that are reaching out to you to try their products, so it's nice that there was somebody that's, you know, sort of local that reached out to me and wanted me to give their product a go, and I would definitely do it again. With that said, all that information that I just gave you about the markers, I hope there's enough there for you to want to go out and try these markers for yourself. Great for working on the wood. I mean, I had a little bit of difficulty, but I'm not a seasoned paint marker user. I don't use paint markers that often, but I mean, I did have fun using them, and I think I ended up with a nice little piece as well. I did kind of try to do a night sky here. It wasn't working out, so I just fixed that up real easy. If you had something that was more of a smoother surface, maybe like a ranger board or something to that extent, or even masonite, you might get a smoother transition in the colors. You can blend them to a certain extent. If you even wanted to, you could pump the paint out and use them with a paintbrush to help you get more of an effect. I did use my finger to help blend some of the colors in. I didn't find anything to state that they weren't safe to get on your skin, so don't do as I do. Go and do some of your own research as well. And lastly here, you saw me using a Copic marker to draw in these little birds. Do not use your Copic markers on top of these paint markers. You will ruin the nibs. That's pretty much everything I have to say about the markers and my experience using them. I do have a few final words, I guess, towards the end of the video here. And there's a little announcement that those of you who have made it this far in the video are going to want to hear. And I tried signing my name with some inks here, but it didn't work, so I just signed the painting on the back. So, but yeah, here's the rest of the video.
Alright guys, there you have it. This is the final piece that I just did. I tried to create a sunset, I guess, sunrise, whichever way you want to take it. I know the gradient is not 100% perfect, but I'm using what I had. One last thing I would like to mention, like, I think I may have been able to do slightly a little bit better of a job with this if I had some more of the fine tip markers rather than just the really big bullet nib. But I did make a nice little painting here, an abstract landscape, so to speak, so I'm really proud of how that turned out. I had fun with this, and that was the main thing. I just wanted to sit down and have fun, show off these really cool markers, and get something nice in return, which is a little painting. So before I go, I just want to have a little announcement. I'm just going to pull the screen back out here. As you can tell, I only used half of the markers that was sent to me. So what I want to do is, these markers here are still in the package. They have not been pumped, so they're brand new, brand spanking new. I want to give these away to one of my viewers, and I did not list in the description of the video that this was a giveaway because I didn't want people to subscribe to my channel or comment to my videos saying that, you know, they want to enter the giveaway away and they're not really a normal viewer. So what I'd like for you to do is that if you want to join in on the giveaway, I'm going to draw a name on the 17th. So leave a comment down below why you would like to try out these markers, and you kind of have to be have your subscriptions as viewable so I can actually go in to see if you're subscribed to me or not. That is the only way that you're going to be entered into the draw, is that if you are subscribed to me and I have proof that you are subscribed to my channel. And what I'm going to do is, everyone who comments down below and I have proof that you are subscribed to my channel, I'm going to put all your names into a random generator. I will record it and I will put up a little segment on the 17th, maybe in my video for that day, showing you who won. And unfortunately, it's only open to Canadian and US residents because I cannot afford to send this as a package overseas. So just to let you know that there's not going to be any kind of you know, announcement in the title of the video. This is only a giveaway to those of you who stay and watch to the very end of the video, and good luck. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.